सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा। अयि भो दशमकक्षायाः छात्राः, अद्य वयं द्वितीयकक्षायां सम्मिलिताः स्मः। दशमकक्षायाः प्रथमः पाठः अस्ति शुचिपर्यावरणं। शुचिपर्यावरणम् इति पाठे अस्माभिः चरणचतुष्टयं पठितम् आसीत्। इदानीं वयम् अत्र तृतीयकक्षायां पञ्चमषष्टसप्तमचरणान् पठामः। अस्याः कवितायाः पञ्चमं चरणम् एवं वर्तते। हरिततरूणां ललितलतानां माला रमणीया। हरिततरूणां ललितलतानां माला रमणीया। कुसुमावलिः समीरचालिता श्यामे वर्णीया। कुसुमावलिः समीरचालिता श्यामे वर्णीया। नवमालिका रसालं मिलिता। नवमालिका रसालं मिलिता। रुचिरं संगमनं शुचिपर्यावरणं। शुचिपर्यावरणं अर्थात् तरुः नाम वृक्षः। हरिततरूणां वसन्तसमये किं भवति, सर्वेपि तरवः हरिताः भवन्ति। ललितलतानां लताः अतीव मनोहराः। ललितं नाम सुन्दरं। ललितलतानां माला रमणीया। प्रकृतौ ग्रामीणप्रकृतौ किमस्ति, हरिततरवः भवन्ति, हरितवृक्षाः भवन्ति, ललितलताः भवन्ति, लताः अपि अतीवसुन्दर्याः भवन्ति। माला रमणीया तासां मालानाम् अर्थात् लतानां वृक्षाणां मालापुञ्जः गुम्फः अतीव रमणीया भवति। रम् अधिकम् अनीयर् प्रत्यये स्त्रीत्वं रमणीया इति भवति। माला इति स्त्रीलिङ्गे अस्ति, तस्मात् माला रमणीया। रमणीया इति अनीयर् प्रत्ययः। एवं कुसुमावलिः। कुसुमावलिः समीरचालिता। कुसुमानाम् आवलिः। वयं दीपावलिः इति भवन्तः जानन्ति। दीपानाम् आवलिः दीपावलिः। अत्र कुसुमानाम् आवलिः। आवलिः नाम पङ्क्तिः। कुसुमावलिः दीपानाम् आवलिः दीपावलिः। कुसुमानाम् आवलिः पङ्क्तिः। कुसुमानां सुमानां प्रसूनं पुष्पं समीरचालिता। समीरः शब्दार्थः। समीरः नाम वायुः पवनः। समीरचालिता का समीरचालिता? कुसुमावलिः। आवलिः इति स्त्रीलिङ्गे अस्ति, तस्मात् चालिता कुसुमावलिः समीरचालिता। स्यान् स्यात् मे स्यान् मे सन्धिः। वर्गस्य प्रथमवर्णस्य स्थाने पञ्चमवर्णस्य आगमः। अनुनासिकसन्धिः अत्र जगत् अधिकं नाथः जगन्नाथः इतिवत् स्यात् अधिकं मे स्यां मे वर्णीया। वृ अधिकम् अनीयर् वर्णीया। नवमालिका नवं नाम नूतनं। मालिका मालाः। रसालं मिलिता। रसालः नाम अन्नवृक्षः। रुचिरं सङ्गमनं। रुचिरं सङ्गमनं शोभते। तेषां सङ्गमनं शोभते। हियर् इन् दिस् stanza once again the poet is explaining the beauty of the nature. Haritatarunam, the trees are very much in green. Lalitalatanam, creepers are looking so beautiful. Mala ramaniya, they are looking like the garland in the nature and it is very much attractive. Kusumavalihi, avalihi means garland. Kusumavalhi, the bunch of the flowers, Samira Chalita, the bunch of the flowers which are there in the creepers, they are just like hanging, Samira Chalita, because the wind blows, they also play along with the wind. Syanme Varaniya, that is the beauty, beautiful scene which I want to see, where the flowers which are hanging in the creepers and the trees which will play with the wind. Navamalika rasalam milita, the new creepers rasalam milita, they are surrounding the mango trees. Ruchiram sangamanam, this is the beauty to see that creepers are joining the trees because shuchi paryavaranam, here the nature is so clean. Aichara bandho khagakula kalarava gunjita vanadesham, aichara bandho khagakula kalarava gunjita vanadesham, pura kalarava sambhramita janebhyo, pura kalarava sambhramita janebhyo, druta sukha sandesham, chaka chakya jalam, chaka chakya jalam, no kurya jivita rasaharanam, shuchi paryavaranam, shuchi paryavaranam. Ai chala bandho, he mitra, chala tu asman, maya sah chala tu, maya sah gacchatu, kutra, yatra vanadeshe, gunjita vanadesham, vanam gunjati, kena gunjati, kaka kula kalarava, kalaravanam shabda, kesham shabda, pakshinam shabda, khagaha, khe gacchati iti khagaha. Tadrushanam pakshinanam kalaravena gunjitam vanadesham chalabandho mitra, tadrusham vanam prati gacchaha. Pura kalarava sambhramita janibhyaha, pura, pura nama nagaram, nagarepi kalarava bhavatu, nagarepi shabda bhavatu, tat kim karoti, sambhramita janibhyaha, brahmam janayati, brahmita bhavati, bhranta bhavati, nagare, yatohi, tatra gacchati, haran shabda, atra gacchati, uyanasi shabda, eteshe shabde vyaha, kim bhavati, matihi brahmita bhavati, ete trishanam nagara jivinam prati, druta sukha sandesham, ekam sukham sandesham dhritva, tadrusham vanam pradesham gacchamah, chaka chakya jalam, chaka chakyata, everywhere. Kutra api nagare sarvam kim karoti, sarvai janaha chaka chakyatam pradarshayanti. Eka chalakaha api atra gacchati tatra gacchati tasya chaka chakyatam pradarshayanti. Bhashane api chaka chakyatam pradarshayanti. Swabhavika ritya bhashanam na kurvanti. Tesham bhasha shailaya chaka chakyatam janayanti. Eta trishinam chaka chakyam prakritikam na bhavati. Kurya jivita rasaharan. Jivane bahu rasam asti. Sukhamasti jivane, parantu etat chaka chakyam jivanasya rasam harati. Asmat etat prasham vihaya gunjita vanadesham charamaha. Such a beautiful stanza. In this stanza, poet is explaining how beautiful it is, the nature is. Ai chala bandho, my dear friend, let us go. Where? Khaga kala kula rava, khaga kula kalarava, kagakulam, the family of the birds, where they are making the noise, gunjita vanadesham, such a forest we will go, where birds are chirping. Pura kalaravasam bhramita janebhyo, the noise in the city, the noise in the city is creating the confusion to the people. Horn sound, factory sounds, so many noises in the city. They are all confusing the people in the city. For them, let us get one good message. Druta sukha sandesham. One happy message we will take. Because there is a peaceful place. That is the forest where the birds are chirping. Such a good place is there. That is the new, we are taking the message to the city people. And what the city people will do? Chaka chakya jalam, they have the webs of artificiality. Anything you go to the city, everything is artificial. The way they talk, the way they do the business, nothing natural. So that unknowing artificiality is developed in the cities. So this artificiality, what it is doing? Kurya jita rasaharam, the life But this artificiality is killing the real beauty of the person. So that's why let us stop this artificiality and go to the nature where the birds are chirping. Let us feel the happiness. Prastaratare latakar gulma no bhavantu pishtaha pashani sabhyatani sarke syanna samavishta manavaya jivanam kamaye no jivan maranam shuchi paryavaranam. Such a beautiful thing it is. Prastaram likantu ativa mukhyam shabdarthe prastaram nama shila pashana lata taru gulmaha no bhavantu pishtaha lata taru gulmaha prastaratare pishtaha na bhavantu pashani sabhyata nisarke syanna samavishta sabhyata nagarikata pashani bhuta artat kadinatvam prapta syanna samavishta nisargena samavishta prakrutota adrishi pashani sabhyata nasyat manavaya jivanam kamaye manushyaya jivanam avashyakam natu jivan maranam jivatah api maranam jivan maranam pachami tatpurusha samasa jivatah jivantah api santi tatapi mrutah eva yato hi jivanase sarante na janam. The meaning is prastaratale lata taru gulma no bhavantu pishtaha. If you go to the mountains under the big stones, some creepers are there, some trees are there, some bushes are there. That means this big stone is stopping their growth. Like this artificiality, what the poet wants to say, which is the big stone, that is the artificiality, is spoiling the life of creepers, trees and the bushes. Who are creepers? Who are the trees and bushes? You and me. Our life is spoiled by the artificiality of the cities. No bhavantu pishtaha. It is submerged, understood. So that way it is pressurized by the artificiality. We are leaving our naturality. So in the life we should enjoy the life, but we should not be suppressed by this artificiality. Pashani sabhyata, civilized people are becoming the stones. Nonsensical. There is no sense, even though you are the civilized, but your civilization doesn't have any values. Pashani sabhyata, it is becoming like a stone. Syanna nisarga samavishta, like this artificiality, uselessness, doesn't come to the nature, mother nature. Manavaya jivanam kamaye, for a man, life should be there. No jivan maranam, we should not live like a dead. Many of the people are living like a dead. Children are not enjoying their childhood because so much they are busy. Naturally they are not growing. They are growing very artificially. They want to see the tree, they will show the artificial tree. They want to see the animals, they will show in the pictures. It is very artificial. You have to see naturally and live. People, affection is also becoming very artificial. Even the civilization is also becoming artificial. The poet tells that we must make the paryavaranam, the nature, clean, so all our things that we do in the life, that becomes the natural. My dear boys, please note down the poems and practice and note down the meanings as well as sandhis. 2 minutes for you.